Okay, so I have the Massey Ferguson 235 in my garage, and if you've seen my videos in the winter, I had some problems with the clutch on it. So now it's time to find out what is wrong with the clutch. And for doing that, we need to split it. We need to remove the engine from the gearbox. That would say the engine or the front part of the tractor is, you need to come off, and we need to take the hood off and maybe some wires, some gas linkage, something like that. And then we can jack it up in both ends, and then we can roll the front forward and leave the back in the position it is, and then we can inspect and see what's wrong with the clutch. If I didn't have this brackets for front loader, I could climb under it and look and find out what's wrong with it, but I need to fix something anyways. So now we need to split it and find out what's wrong. So that's what we are doing today. We are splitting it. It's fall. Winter can be here anytime. You can see the smoke from my breath. It's getting colder, and we can have snow in one day, we can have snow in 2 months, who knows. But it's been raining for 4 weeks straight now. I'm pretty sick and tired of it. And I'm also trying to finish up all excavation jobs, so that's also something. But we will start with this tractor. We will take the hood off. It's just bolts here and a couple of bolts in here, and I also need to remove this weatherproofing I did last winter. So just some screws down here and it should be really easy. So that's the plan for today. Just get everything apart and find out what's wrong with it, and then we can order parts for it. So here we can see the split really good, because I had the engine out some time ago, a couple of years ago, and rebuilt the whole engine. New bearings, new pistons, new sleeves for the pistons, new valves, new valve seals, everything was built new. It was only the block and the top, and yeah, that we kept. And also I have to mention, the reason I'm doing this is normally I wouldn't do this before the snow was probably on the ground, and I had some panic because I need to clear some snow and the clutch didn't work and stuff like that. But I actually bought a used tractor, another tractor. It's newer than this one, that is, but it isn't new, so I don't know what is it with me and old tractors, but I'd rather with the 165, but this one is a lot newer, but that one we'll see later. Let's now concentrate on the 235. So the hood is off, and I disconnected the positive cable from the starter and put some tape around it so it doesn't shortcut. And I also taken off the ground from the battery, so now it shouldn't be any problem anyways. And this was a wire I had going up for this preheating. So now everything is loose from the starter, and we can remove the start engine from the engine, and then we can start loosening some bolts and maybe soon put some jacks under and getting ready for taking everything apart. Thank you. everything is mostly ready now for separating. I have loosened most of the bolts, just one here, and the same on the other side. And then everything is ready for being separated. I have my jack stands here, so I will try and use them to secure the back end, and then I will have the front on this garage jack, and I can move it up and down a little bit and use this one with the wheels to pull it forward, and then secure it with these jack stands. Then we have the back supported on jack stands. See, we have almost no pressure on the front, so we are now just draining the fuel system. I removed the fuel pipe on this feed pump, and I have also loosened it here on the filter, so as we can see, it's ready for coming apart. And this should be it. Okay, we have the stop. This is the control for the stop, so it's going here on the pump. That one also needs to come apart. That. Okay. Now it's ready. It's nothing left. It's just the few bolts that I hadn't removed, and when they are off, we should be able to pull it forward. I've been fiddling with this for now for a good 30 minutes and I can't get it apart. It's really difficult to get the back part to line up with the front part, so I probably need one more jack, garage jack, just to make everything level with the jack, and then I can pull it apart. Also, the last time I did this, I used a little Kubota. I just removed the gas tank with the fuel tank here and just put some ropes in it and lifted everything up with the Kubota and pulled it apart. Lot easier. I took the front also off because the Kubota could only lift the engine barely. So I should have put the tractor with the front against the door, then it would have been easier. I could just get the Terex and just put some ropes in it and pull it apart without any problems. I figured out I'd try something new, and the thing that is missing is a little bit forward pull on this one. So now I have this ratchet strap into the building and to the front, and with this hopefully I can make it move. So I'm back with my Massey Ferguson, and I don't know if I got it on tape or not, but we got it apart and we got it split it, and the clutch is in a few days now, so I need to make everything ready so I can put everything back together and line up the engine with the gearbox. And let's take a look at that. Okay, so this is how it looks when everything is apart. We can see here, we now have distance between the clutch and the gearbox. And I used the floor jack and jack stands to pull it off. It was not ideal. If I was supposed to do this again, I would turn the tractor around and use the excavator on the outside to lift the engine and everything. But we got it apart. It's not lined up now. You can see it's a big difference between the shaft here and this one. And if I put it up on the clutch, it can pivot on the front axle, so the engine is tipping forward and backward. So what I'm planning to do now is to make some wheels and some plates and weld something, some stand for it, that it fits directly in there with some bigger wheels, so it's easier to push everything in when it's done. And I can also take everything here out and change the clutch and everything. And we can see here, the part that I have failed is the bearing that is releasing the clutch. So it's grind off, and you can see this is the holder for it, and here, and the balls for the bearings and everything is lying down here. And if we can see it here, let's see, oops, the arms are also grind down, that is releasing the clutch here. So I need to change everything there. So, and it was tilting again, you can see how wobbly it is. So let's go and make some wheels and some stands for the engine, so we can push it this way and push it back when we need to. This is what I'm making the stand of. I got these wheels, I got some steel laying around, and the wheels are 24.5 centimeters high, so I only need 13.5 centimeters more to be at the right height. And I'm planning to use this angle iron and just drill some holes in it in the right place for the placement of the bolts on the engine, and maybe use this smaller angle iron and stiffen everything up, and this in between the wheels. So then it's just start cutting. Now welded together and ready to take with me in the other garage and see if it will fit the engine. Test 3. I have now made a small dimp there, so should be able to fit under the flywheel. So let's see. I need to come a little bit higher still with the engine. One in place. Okay, it fits. Supported engine. See if we can. some wires have been added later and some sooner, and yeah, they are not in the same place. All right, that worked pretty good. We now have the room we need for changing out the clutch and everything. So I ordered a new carrier for the clutch bearing here, a new bearing, new arms, new PTO clutch, and new main clutch, and the springs and everything for this new. So if I don't remember wrong, here is actually some bolts also that is hitting the clutch fly, the bearing, so it has really grinded off. So no wonder why the clutch wasn't working anymore. You can see all this debris from the clutch or the bearing going in every piece, and you can see this PTO clutch is a little bit off from this, so probably need to align everything when we're putting it back together. This bolt broke. So the clutch is actually not bad. It's in okay condition, but since we have everything apart, we just change out everything, including this bearing. For taking this clutch housing apart, I need to release the pressure from these arms, and then I can pull out the pin that holds the arms in, and then I can take off this cover part. So by doing that, I will put it in the press like now. I have a beam over, and let's see when we press down. Yeah, you can see the arms are going in, so we are releasing pressure from them. Okay, that's enough. Now we can just leave it there, and then I'll take the pins out. The spring is actually broken, so I need to order a new spring. Damn it. See here, it's the leftovers. So, I'm not reassembling today then. exhaust pipe, but I guess it will hold for a bearing. There it is. New bearing in place. One more thing I'm doing with this tractor now when I have it apart is, or have it for service, is changing out this elbow with the new exhaust all the way up. You can see it's rusted away under here, so it's a hole, so it's leaking exhaust. So let's see if we can get these bolts off. I'm not sure it's possible, but yeah, we'll give it a try. If not, I have an angle grinder and I'm not afraid to use it. Just spinning on the... Yep. Got it. Wow. Oh yeah, you be for the win. Meter on. Nope. Oh yes. There. I don't know if it's an amazing tool or, yeah, I think this one was pretty loose, but now it's ready for a new bolt. Okay, it has been a week and I got some more parts, so we are getting ready for reassembling this clutch for the Massey Ferguson 240. Got some new bolts for the one I broke, and yeah, springs, and hopefully now I think everything we need for reassembling. Should also have some splints here. Should be somewhere. sort this. This is some bushings for the springs. So we just go new with everything, since we are like this. Some kind of cardboard or something. Springs. Okay, they come separately packed, one and one. Perfect. Okay, so I do have the workshop manual for this Massey Ferguson. I will put a link in this description. And one important thing is that all the bolts need to come in from this side. Also for the bolts that we are putting in there, also have to come from the same side. So I don't know why, but the manual says so, so I guess it's right. No hanging on the alignment tool, so it's just getting the screws in. Then we can torque the clutch in place with the flywheel. Now we can adjust these nuts. I checked the workshop manual and they say 198 to 208 millimeters. So
Here I have these measuring blades. So we have 0.9 and 1, so we have 1.9 and 0.10. That should be 2. So right in the middle of it. And then we can see here. And I think this one is just right about where it should be. We can tighten it a little bit. Same there. Okay, there I can feel a little bit of resistance. Not much room, but me and my friend did try to get this tractor back together after the clutch have been adjusted and everything ready for putting back together the other day, but we had some trouble. This is as far as we got it, and you can see we are missing a little bit, and it's probably the splines in the clutch and the drive shaft that won't line up perfectly. And I was thinking today I would try something else, and that's putting a The last time when we tried, we had the tractor in free and the PTO disengaged, and we could spin on this flywheel to try and line it up. But probably when we are spinning on the flywheel, the drive shaft will only turn with it because it's not locked anyways. So now I will try and put the tractor in gear and engage the PTO and see if that will help getting it back together. So let's see if that helps. If not, just keep fiddling with it. Been in and had some dinner, and it's still apart, and this strap is not much pressure on. It's just a little bit for holding pressure in while I'm turning on the engine and everything. So but it's just continuing trying to get it together. As we can see, it's snow out now, so it's about time. I will try and adjust the jacks and everything and just see if I can't get it to line up perfectly, and then it should just pop in. So I will start the time lapse and do that. Finally I got it together. So I just what I did last, if you've seen the time lapse, you could see I pulled it apart and I just released the clutch all the way, so it's all the way back. I put in the alignment tool again and just made sure it was, the clutches was aligned properly, and you can see now it's not moving anymore. I used a minute now about figuring it out, and yeah, well, I think that's why. The bolts for my wheels are touching the gearbox now, so that's why. So now I just need to release the bolts and the nuts, and then it will glide together and we can just continue putting everything back together. And yeah, really exciting. It was a little bit work to get everything together again. The final gap. Back together again. Woohoo! Then the Massey Ferguson is back together, and as we could see on the video, it moves forward, backwards, and the PTO clutch is working better than ever. So I done something right. Yeah, then the Massey Ferguson is actually ready for winter. Now it's just putting the hood on when the smoke have cleared out of the garage, and yeah, remove the swimming pool and stuff, and yeah, as we can see, the winter is here. I was really hoping that we would get, yeah, maybe one more period without snow, but yeah, it is what it is.